Hello everyone, SBI Architects here today. I want to show you how to create realistic terrain landscape for your architectural projects. Sometimes it's not necessary to making this, but sometimes, for instance, this project, your project might be inside a very prominent place and you need to show it. In this situation, we have a lake here and our customer want to see the lake from the house. Therefore, I wanted to model the site. Now, let's see together how we can do this. I will create a new project for you. Alright, here we are in the ArchiCAD, and at the very first, I want to change the unit system from project preferences, working units. I prefer using centimeter. Yes, click OK. Now we need a JPEG for doing this. You can get it from Google Earth. Let's go to Google Earth. By the way, if you don't have Google Earth, you need to download it first. It must be Google Earth Pro. In the search bar, you can input Google Earth Pro and you will see this web page. From here, you will download this Google Earth Pro on desktop. You won't click this Launch Earth. We will use Google Earth Pro. I will give the link to description so you can download from there. Alright, now we are in Google Earth Pro. Since I'm living in Turkey, it's showing us Turkey position. Let's go to my city. I'll type here Antalya. Let's say that we will save this view. Maybe this place. But while we are saving, we need high resolution. Therefore, we will change our save settings. But first, let's go to File menu and click Save. And we will click this Save View. After that, you will see some labels opened. You can just turn off them or you can leave turned on. It's the best to you. And here we will see this resolution and we will see this maximum value. Just click it and now it will be saved as this value. It will be very huge file for your information. Maybe we can get a bit closer here. And I want to turn off roads and other letters from here. Let's uncheck them. But I will turn on this scale. If you turn on this, you will see this scale line. You can scale your project according to the scale line. Once we have set up, we will click this save the view. It will be a long process or short process depending to your computer. Alright, let's open up our file. And if we zoom inside, we can see details. And by the way, you can see this line will be equal to 30 meters. Okay, now we can import our image to ArchiCAD file. Let's double click our file or click open. And place. There we go, we have placed our JPEG to our ground floor. Let's just get rid of these sections. Okay. Now we need to scale this up. This is going to be 30 meters. Let's click our JPEG. Hit Ctrl plus K. And this will be checked on. Define graphically. Let's click the center of the line. Hit the Shift. And click the second center of line and we will input here 30 meters. Just like that. Now our scale is complete. If we hit the M, for instance, we can measure the road. This road is 5 meters. Its sidewall is 150. Once we have achieved this, we can go to the mesh tool and we can create our mesh on the top of our JPEG. If you want to see your JPEG, you can click your mesh, click this icon and uncheck cover fields. There we go. Now, let's go to 3D window and we have this. As you can guess, we need to change the texture of this terrain. Therefore, we are going to create a new one. Let's go to surface. From the options, element attributes, click surfaces. I want to click new and instead of using this new from catalog, we can use duplicates. And for instance, terrain near Antalya. Let's click OK. And we will browse our JPEG inside. From load image from library dialog, we will click this add. Once you have added your JPEG, you will see this in the embedded library folder. Click OK. And click OK. Let's click our terrain and change its new surface to our new surface. This one. But we have a big problem. Our scale is not matched with the terrain. To fix this, we need to measure our terrain distances. From here to here, it's 43,022. From here to here, it's 73,763. We can write down on the paper and use again. Or you can just use notepad. Measure up and type it. We have two value, x and y. This is going to be y. It's correct. And our x value is 73,763. Yeah, now they're ready. Let's go back to surface again. Select your new terrain and type your x value to here and y value to here. We can just copy and paste. Just like that. Let's click OK. And in the 3D window, it will be changed according to your size. But the position is not correct. Let's fix it too. Let's click it. Click the document, creative imaging, align 3D texture, and click set origin. Our origin will be here. If you click wrong, you can follow the same step and correct your image origin. Okay, once we have done that, let's go to our layering process. I want to give some layers, height, and some depth to our terrain. I don't know the real values. I'm gonna make eyeball. If you have your values, of course you can use that values. Anyway, let's go to document and click spline. We will have different values. First value will be start from here. You can be very detailed, or you can make this roughly. I want to make this short, therefore I'm doing this fast. After placing your points, you can fix them later. The important thing is the place of your points. I will show you. Let's click our spline, and from the geometry method, we will click this Bezier. And now we can see our Beziers and fix them. First, click your point. And click your desired point. We have another one here. Maybe we can fix this desired point. Or something like this. Anyway, you get the point. Once we have this, we will duplicate the spline to its same position and offset to very near to itself. Just like that. They will be combined as C layer. Now let's come to our second spline. For this terrain, there are serious layers inside. But as you can see, it's roughly visible. We have a serious layer here. Therefore, we will follow this position. By the way, we have a castle here. Just like that. Now, the final step will be clicking your terrain. Go to design. Click the mesh. And we will hit the spacebar. You will see a new dialog, new mesh points. You will click OK here. Do it again for your whole splines. And the final one. Now, this one will be -2. And we will click this apply to all. Those supplies will be equal to 0. It's okay. And this one, I don't know, maybe 50 meters. Apply to all and click OK. Since this was 50 meters, this point will be maybe 17 meters. But this time we won't click hit apply. If you click, your button points will be changed. We don't want to do that. Maybe 16. But this one will be equal to this one. -2. You will see this terrain helpers will be gone. But you will see this terrain helpers now. We have this, we can see them because we have slopes here. Serious slopes. There we go. In the 3D window, we will see this. Now, let's just get rid of the lines. Let's click our terrain. Click the option. And from the ridge selection, show all ridges. This is going to be user defined ridges. This was fixed in the floor plan. And in the 3D window, we will fix them in the settings. We will use this all is smooth or user defined sharp. just like that. I want to change this height with my eyeball. It must be something like this. There you go. Now you can use this C, or instead of that, you can create yours. Let's click the mesh. And from here, I don't know, maybe to here, make a rectangle. And from the surface, let's change it to any kind of border material, maybe like this. And you can change the bottom elevation to this bottom corner. And now it's ready. If we have unwanted point elevations, you can fix them like this. Now you can export your model to D5 or T-Motion, and you can place your trees and your building and take your render. Alright guys, that's all for this video tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed and learned something new. If so, please hit the like button. And if you subscribe the channel, you won't miss any future tips and tutorials. Thank you for watching. Until next time, have a nice day. Bye.